actually believe that sort of he needs to fire them to save his presidency?
There are so many things in this book, both big and little, that I'd love to cover. I'll start with the big and then go to a few of the little. But you just said they're dangerous.
Yes.
Why do you think they're dangerous?
Well, let's start with the fact that instead of solving Middle East peace, Jared nearly put us into a war in the region. You know, his taking over control of the State Department, basically, taking Rex Tillerson's portfolio out of his hands, particularly in the Middle East, his complete control of the relationship with MBS in Saudi Arabia meant that he kind of got played by MBS. He pushed for Trump to hold this. The first official American visit was not to a country with shared democratic values, but to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, with this brutal regime. The theme of the summit was all about cooperation. Days later, the Saudis made a mockery of the United States by turning around and blockading with U.S. support that Rex Tillerson firmly believed was Jared. They blockaded Qatar. They wanted Qatar's money. Qatar has an American airbase. That is our security on the line. That was when Rex Tillerson and Jim Mattis, the defense secretary, who had no idea about any of this, thought that Jared went from being a really annoying obstacle and meddler to being downright dangerous.
And you suggest, in regards to this in particular, to Qatar, which is Saudi Arabia and Qatar have been at odds for a long time, and that almost moved to a full-out shooting war,
mm-hmm.
You suggest or imply that Jared Kushner had a financial interest in Qatar and may have been acting out of a sense of revenge, that Qatar wouldn't invest with him? Explain.
Yes, so Charles Kushner had just asked the Qataris for $1 billion to save a building that was a financial catastrophe for the Kushner family. The Qataris at that point turned him down. And lo and behold, our foreign policy turns negative towards them. I will have to say that a year later, when the Qataris are offering money, our foreign policy changes. The U.S. no longer supports the blockade.
Now, you, in the title of the book, you use the word corruption here, and you
yes.
write a lot about Jared Kushner here. Is there proof yet? And what I mean proof is there legal action that you have seen or heard from in the people you've talked to against Jared Kushner? Because Lord knows he's been under investigation for the mm-hmm. last 2 years. The Mueller investigation seems to have been very broad and dealt exclusively
yes.
or extensively, I should say, with foreign interests here. Do you think they found any evidence of foreign influence or corruption over Jared Kushner?
Well, I say in the book that Mueller has definitely passed a lot of that stuff off to more appropriate avenues because, you know, there's a lot of Middle Eastern money. And Mueller was, you know, found himself interviewing, for example, the Lebanese businessman George Nader. You know, that's not going to be part of his report, which is all about Russia, right? Though all that business stuff, I think you're going to see sent to New York.
Do you think he's in legal jeopardy, Jared Kushner?
Well, look, we know Congress is already looking into the 666 deal and what happened with Qatar. I think there is a lot of smoke in my book. The Oversight Committee is reading it.
Let's talk about Ivanka Trump, if we
yes.
can.